I have in the studio, of course, two artists, one artist actually from the Lindale Arts Guild, and that's Cerid.
Hello.
How are you?
Not bad. How's
yourself? I am very good. And of course, you're the woman who's put most of this together up here.
Yes, that would be right.
Cool. And we have Theo here. How are you, Theo?
Kia ora. How's it going? Yeah, good. Thank you for having me. Yeah.
No worries. And you're going to be legendary because you are going to be making the cheese up at Lindale look fantastic and maybe a little less like a bit of cheese. Or
yeah, probably add a bit more colour to
a bit more spice to our cheese.
A bit more spice, yeah.
Well, we see today that it already has because there's a shopping trolley over there. And well, you reckon you might sort of embed the shopping trolley into your art?
Who knows, eh? We'll see.
Yeah.
It's very exciting.
Because you did the toilets down at Otahunga Domain, is that correct?
Yeah, me and I worked with some students from Paraparaumu College and I think from Kapiti College as well on those.
Looks pretty cool.
Yeah,
it's a lot better than it was down there.
But it's nice to add a little bit of colour to complement the already beautiful area that it is.
And I think you actually did that quite well. It wasn't like you don't go down there and see like this eyesore. It sort of blends into what's down there. So it's cool.
Yeah, beautiful. Thank you.
No problems at all. Okay, so Cerid, you said you want to talk all about your art.
Actually, I'm really interested in, obviously the listeners have been hearing over the last few weeks, some of the guild artists have been coming through. So I think it'd be a really nice opportunity to talk just a little bit about the guild and how that developed and why we've got it. Mm-hmm. So the guild originally actually had its starting points in Basement Artworks, which was a gallery that Theo and I actually managed for a little while earlier this year. And I had the opportunity to work with some amazing artists there who haven't actually done a lot in Kapiti. They haven't presented their work very frequently before. And that was a really good chance to start to communicate with them. They're artists who sort of feel that they work a little bit differently than most Kapiti artists. Not to say there's anything wrong with the way most Kapiti artists work, by any means, it's fantastic. I mean, Kapiti is just such an amazing hub. Actually, we've got more artists here in Kapiti per capita than anywhere else in New Zealand, which is amazing.
Have you counted?
No, I haven't, but some stats have come out recently, apparently. So
I'll believe you. I was only just winding up. That's all good.
Starting to work with them and realising that a lot of them are really looking for an outlet and a kind of a community to be involved with art, where they feel that they're working with people in sort of similar ideas to them or more sort of outside the box stuff. They also tend to be younger on the scale of things, so they get coined the term having fresh artists, which I quite like, you know, something a bit fresh. So when Arts Trail opportunity sort of came up, I was already working with these guys to kind of go, okay, what could we do? What could we start to develop and build? And then we thought once we got the opportunity I got the opportunity up here at Lindale to look at having a hub for Kapiti Arts Trail, the team up here said, well, yeah, look, we'd really be happy to host an artist guild that could do some exhibitions and some shows here that would be a little bit different. So that was very, very exciting. And from then, by word of mouth from other artists who were already involved in the guild, already involved from Basement, we started to find a few more who were a little bit outside the box. And I think now we have a total of 11 artists and we're hoping to grow and develop. And we'll see really where that group wants to take this idea. We're all about celebrating diversity and being an eclectic group of people, so we're not looking for anything specific in any way, shape or form. Anyone is welcome to say, hey, look, I'd like to be involved, and the group of us will get together and go, hey, cool, do we think this matches our sort of idea of where we're wanting to go, and just see how it develops.
Very cool. Sounds good. Hey, it's good that you've got 11 artists already involved in it.
Yeah, absolutely.
And they're going to be all displaying over in the barn?
Yes, they are. So very exciting. The barn has been an amazing project to work on. I'm not a builder, never have been. And I've had a friend of mine, Khan Glennie-Binding, who's just dedicated so much of his free time, which is very, very little, and spent time up in the barn helping me put together some new walls to create a gallery space. So it's very cool. Rustic and a little bit punk in some ways.
Sounds good to me.
Out of pallet boxes, but it's a fantastic art space, and we're really looking forward to seeing what's going to develop there from here.
Sounds good to me. All right, we're going to, as always on the show, we talked a bit about your music. And Theo, you had your sort of first choice. And what was your first choice on the music front?
Yeah, it's a song I've been cranking in the studio at the moment. It's called Colours by Black Pumas. And cool. I think you'll like it.
Are you like me? You get a favourite song, you just kill it to death?
Definitely.
Yeah,
I have a few at the moment that I've just been playing on repeat, pretty much annoying the neighbours, I think. Yeah.
Sounds good to me. So that's what we've got coming up next. We've got Colours and Black Pumas. Well, the other way around, shall I say.
The Beach FM Sunday Afternoon Show with Paraparamu Taxis. Your friendly team at your service 24/7. Just call 296-1111.
I woke up to the morning sky first. Baby blue, just like we rehearsed. When I get up off this ground, I shake leaves back down to the brown, 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 till I'm clean. Then I walk, I'll be shaded by the trees, by a meadow of green, oh, by the mountain. I'm headed to town, 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 in the sky, with all my favorite colors,
yes, sir.
All my favorite colors, my sisters and my brothers, see them like no other, all my favorite colors. It's a good day.
On Beach FM 106.3, and that is a very cool song by the Black Pumas and Colours, and that was Theo's choice. But first, we've just got to go find some missing animals.
Beach FM Pet Patrol brought to you by Composting New Zealand Limited, providing bulk landscape supplies to the Kapiti Coast. Open 7 days at 160 Otaihanga Road, Paraparaumu.
All right, Aelia has found a cat down on the Ratanui Road, and it is a very fluffy black and white cat. It's very friendly. It's making friendly noises and seems to be hanging around their place down there. So if you're missing your cat down there, look at it. She says it seems like a female. I'm not sure how you tell it seems like a female. I was going to say something really sort of un-PC and sexist, but I won't because my wife might be listening and then I'll be in trouble when I get home. But it seems like a female. So if you're missing your really cute, fluffy black and white cat down Ratanui Road, Ayla has it. So go on the Lost and Found Pets Cat Facebook page and see if you can your cat's there. All right, back to talking about art, and I've got Theo and your name just went straight from my head onto there, which is really good. But
I'm known by many things.
You?
It's fine. Well, hey you.
Hey you. Perfect. Hey you works. Very good. Right, Theo, we're going to chat to you about your art and your trip and et cetera, et cetera. And
cool, yeah.
Yeah, so we can basically go. Just tell us about it.
Oh, fantastic.
We'll probably start with, I know it's probably a difficult question, what inspires you?
What inspires me? Life in general. I mean, that's a pretty general answer, but
original.
But I live a very artistic life, I think, and I kind of look for art in everything. So art is my form of communication, one of my main forms of communication. So it's just life in general, for sure.
Cool. And you're saying you're heading off traveling, and you've just been traveling, is that right?
Yeah. So I spent 6 weeks over in the States recently, and I'm pretty keen to go back pretty soon. So it was super inspiring, absolutely incredible journey for sure.
What part of the States?
Flew into LA, spent a few days there, and then shot out to the desert in Arizona.
Cool.
For a while, and then up to Oregon, hung out in Oregon for a lot of the time. It was beautiful. I actually spent a lot of time outside of cities.
Yeah,
and more in nature and stuff like that.
I once many years ago drove from LA to New York across the southern states, and we had this really, really useless car that broke down all the time, but it turned out to be quite cool because we'd break down in the middle of nowhere and we met all these really lovely people who helped us out, and quite a number down the south tried to take us to their church and convert us, but hey, they were friendly and lovely, and they fed us well, the food was good, but in a way it was good that we had a car that broke down because we got to see places that we'd never see before.
Yeah, cool. Like we were driving through the desert at one point, and I was thinking, like, oh, if we broke down, maybe we would become the food. But then, we didn't break down. But if we did, it would have been, I'm glad that you had a good experience.
It was, actually. We had one that I did think we were going to become the food because we broke down, and it wasn't Arizona. I think we must have got through, I think it was just through into New Mexico. And we broke down in the middle of the night. There's nothing around. I'm like, And my mechanical skills are not good. My girlfriend at the time, well, now she's my wife, was not really impressed with me that we'd brought this car and broken down out in there. But this ute pulled up, and seemed to be only a two-seater ute, but about six people got out of it. And it looked like at a Deliverance, and I'm thinking, this is the end. We're going to be – but they were lovely. They were brilliant. We all jumped on the back of the ute. They towed the car. They fixed it. One of them was a mechanic. He got the car going, and we're like, cool.
Nice.
They'd never heard of New Zealand. That was all right. I'm pretty sure they thought we were making it up, but but it was all good. Yeah. Oh, that's going to be great. And you also said you're going to stop in a Bali, get a bit of
get some inspiration over in Bali for sure. I've always wanted to go to a tropical island, so go hang out there for a while, get inspired, and hopefully do some painting over there if possible.
You have a horrible life. Sounds terrible.
I know. I'm super blessed. I love it, and I have a lot of support as well. A lot of support from my family and community and things like that. So
All right, Cerid.
Yes.
Any trips for you to Bali shortly? Or something?
No, I wish. Yeah. I mean, maybe I can fit in Theo's suitcase. I might try.
Give it a crack. I reckon you'd get in there. And in Bali, you don't need many clothes or anything.
I've already got the dreadlocks, so I just fit in just right.
We can get you the barbed wire.
Not a problem. I've got some room left. Okay. Yeah, absolutely.
Excellent.
Maybe we can take Mikey Herman, one of our studio artists here with us, and he can do some tattooing over there as well.
Now, quickly on the tattoo in front, do you paint your tattoos?
Like, do I plan them?
Like on you, because I've got two daughters who are getting tattoos at the moment, and I said, look, you're going to look like someone's doodle pad, because there's these tattoos arriving all over you. Maybe have a plan, have a master. But they said that's not how it works.
I mean, everyone's different. I think it's quite funny. A lot of people say, you know, now, like, you know, why you want to get covered in ink. I mean, for me, it's about being walking art, for one thing. And two, our retirement homes in another 30, 40 years are going to be filled with people with doodles all over them, you know. So we'll be able to make artworks by putting each other's arms together and make whole new pictures there. So I don't see that being a problem. But no, I'm actually not a favourite client of a lot of tattooists as an artist myself. Yeah. I'm a little bit control freaky. I have ideas about what I'd like. I've tattooed around and tattooing myself. So I kind of be a little bit high maintenance. So mine are well planned. The only one that isn't is the one I actually get the most compliments about to this day, ironically.
What's it going to be like in the retirement homes in years to come? Because you know, skin stretches, so you're going to have to put, this is what it used to look like, and you can pull it out.
Use pigs. Yeah, bulldog clips and pigs.
Excellent.
Tighten the skin up.
Sounds like a good plan. All right, we're going to shoot back into the music again, and this time it is your choice, Cerid. And what's your choice?
So I've got a choice, Sound of Rum Balance. It's vocalised by Kate Tempest, who's one of my literary and musical heroes. She's absolutely amazing.
Sounds good to me. So we've got that coming up after the break.
The sand, the surf, the beach. Beach FM, proud to be local.
Ooh, what a shocker. The Beach FM Kapiti Golf Open Tournament is on the 2nd of November at the Kapiti Golf Club, Valley Road, Parapara-Umu. Entries for this popular event close on Sunday, 27th of October. Entry fee is $30 for this 18-hole Level 4 Order of Merit event. Entry forms available at the Kapiti Golf Club, online at sporty.co.nz or via the WGI website. Make up a team or enter on your own. The Beach FM 106.3 Kapiti Golf Open, November 2nd.
Coasters Musical Theatre's next highly entertaining show is Adrian, an alternative pantomime, not for little ears. Although not your traditional panto, it does have all the traditional elements. The show centres on three main characters, Adrian, Red Riding Hood and Dame Dong, who set out to cure all the problems of Pantoland in a fun-filled, laugh-a-minute show. Tickets are $20 and are available through trybooking.com, or you can phone 021 027 1885. The show runs from the 21st to the 30th of November at Coasters Musical Theatre, 15 Inamo Street, Parapara-Umu.
Firm friends. Ambition was the youngest, a bright-eyed kid with a numbness where his logic should have been, cause he was ruled by his hungers. Then there was pride, he walked with the broad stride, cause he from himself would his weaknesses hide, and people liked being near him, didn't know whether they loved him or feared him, it's more they found his self-confidence endearing. Then there was talent, she was beautiful, gallant, but she lived for her senses and not for her sense, and so her poor heart was covered in dents. Oh, her poor heart was covered in dents. Oh, this was envy. Now envy's eyes often seemed empty. She would talk loud in lengthy sentences, frenzied, sensitive, tall and cold. Her eyes were green like skin when it's marked by fake gold. They grew up, fell out, made up, got drunk, hung out from sun up to sun, and then they got done, and then they hit the ground running, looked for and found something, but it all turned to nothing. Though when pride got with talent, envy with ambition, they forgot how to listen. Things changed, became different, everything was competition. Oh, talent and pride became bitter, despised. They got hateful, sarcastic, dreary and drastic. Yes, they loved each other greatly, but their fights were terrible. Raised each other high up on pedestals, isolated themselves, stopped speaking to ambition and envy. They became distant and unfriendly. Envy got sad and cried plenty. Her indignation roused. She discovered she wanted more than she had found with ambition. Cause he was always looking, but only got what he was given. Concerned not with what his hands held, but what they could be gripping. He was always chasing, never thought to fill the space. And envy made him more desperate with every point in conversation. Forcing them comparisons, making him address how every time he promised more, she always ended up with less. making him a dress. So every time he promised more, she always ended up with less. Yes, four firm friends became four fierce forces, heading for that awkward stage that precedes most divorces. Four joint segments of a one-body party just drifted apart and turned nasty. But look, pride keeps envy at bay. Ambition helps talent become more than just a parrot. Yes, and talent, it will flourish. This will enable pride, which quells envy. They should exist side by side, because these factors contribute to balance. Alone, pride is often envious of talents. It seems many have ambition, but talent they haven't. And some have talent, but they're envious of proud ambition. And so alone, these four friends came to realize without the others are just a quarter of what they ought to be. But everything occurs accordingly. Now when they meet up, conversation seems to flow awkwardly. So now they're living separate lives, thinking there used to be more to me. These factors contribute to balance, balance. Alone, pride is often envious of talents, talents.
You're on Beach FM 106.3, and that was The Sound of Rum and Balance. My version of The Sound of Rum wasn't very good because my first year at university, probably my second night at university, we played drinking games with rum, and I can't even stand the smell of it now. It nearly killed me. I decided that night I wasn't a pirate. that wore me down a little bit. Right, Cerid, you're going to earn your keep now because we've got the Kapiti Law listening post coming up, and you're going to do it.
So alrighty, bring it on.
Right, so we'll play the intro and then you'll be on.
Beach FM Listening Post with your community law partners, Kapiti Law. Now with two easy access offices on Main Road Waikanae just by the lights and on Rimu Road Paraparaumu just beside the council chambers.
This weekend, Saturday the 2nd, Sunday the 3rd, is the premiere of Kapiti Coast Arts Trail. There's over 100 listings on their Arts Trail guide this weekend, and one of them you should definitely check out is the Lindale Hub. Up here at Lindale, there will be around 20 artists displaying with some music and various other bits and pieces. It's a field of wonderment for you, so do make sure you get out and check that and visit all the other artists as well. They've worked very, very hard for this all year.
I like that, field of wonderment. That sounds intriguing to me. So.
Well, you clearly haven't seen the amazing work that Umbrella Multimedia have been working on for the Lindale Hub up here with the new up-and-coming stars, the Biddies. Coined the phrase wonderment for the Arts Trail. Yeah. That's absolutely amazing. If you haven't seen that, do look that up on Facebook. It's absolutely hilarious.
I will go have a look at that on there. Hey, if you want your notice on the Kapiti Law listening post, you can give us a call, 0429 6 1400. You could email us at beachfm@carpety.co.nz. You could even fax us, but I wouldn't be able to work out where the fax comes from because I haven't used a fax machine in ages. But there is a fax number, 0420 902 7234, or you can send us a message on Facebook, or you can just drop it in. Alright, we're going to chat more to our friends here, but we are going to have to go pay some bills and play some ads, because we've been chatting too much and I haven't been playing the ads, so I'll get in trouble. But I am going to play some ads, and then we're going to go straight to your next song, Theo, and your next song is?
My next song is The No Problemos, La-Di-Da, featuring Razor Beezer. Yeah.
Sounds good to me.
Kapiti represent.
Yeah. I'm looking forward to, we've got some good news coming up soon, so keep an eye out for the No Problemos Kapiti.
Sounds good to me. We'll certainly keep an eye out for that. You're on Beach FM.
The Beach FM Sunday Afternoon Show with Paraparaumu Taxis. Your friendly team at your service 24/7. Just call 296-1111.
Hi, Stephen here from Kapiti Tempin Bowling and Family Entertainment Centre. We have the ultimate venue for children's birthday parties, with three packages to choose from, all including food, drink and entertainment. What's great for the parents? We clean up the mess. These are a great day out for the kids and a great way to celebrate the special day. Ring to book on 298 3674 for the best birthday party at Kapiti Tempin Bowling and Family Entertainment Centre.
Kapiti Law is proud to support local community events, and this year are a major sponsor of the 2019 Strawberry Festival, being held on Saturday 23rd of November, Kapiti Primary School, and all of the proceeds go to the Mary Potter Hospice. There are many activities, entertainment, and of course, beautiful strawberry and ice cream for your family to enjoy. So get along for a fun day out and join Kapiti Law in support of your local hospice.
Kapiti Law at the lights, Waikanae and Rimu Road, Paraparaumu. Yeah, should I chase the paper? That sure as hell a way to play it safer. But will it be worthwhile when I meet my maker? Be looking back at all the good times lost. When I should have climbed off and said goodbye, I'm off chasing dreams. Don't want this make-believe, it's all just too fake to me. I can wait patiently if patience is key. Cause basically the world is chasing me while I'm off chasing dreams. I only pray they ain't forsaking me, stay with me please. I'm waiting for this rain to cease. Shit, I'm only praying for peace, legit. Like I'm trying to find a 9 to 5 days of the week. It's got me flicking through the pages on seek. But I've been saying I'm sweet. I'm waiting as the days become weeks. Feel I'm fading as I'm gaining no leads. I'm overtaking the speeds I couldn't reach when my foot freaking flat on the floor. Cause every time a day be looking back, it's me that they saw. Peace of mind is paramount. Standing at this roundabout, sounding out my exit like stressing out. I've been obsessed about it too long. Get my coupon has expired, man. It's got me feeling too tired, man. So I take a snooze like a lion, man. The difference is I don't feel king. Been living life on the basis of I guess we'll see. It's what the rest will be. But now it's time for me to ride my own destiny.
Because I'm alone from the highs of my peaks. I keep searching for the peace that I seek. Catch your eyes by the mountain, set by the sea. Together by the fire, sitting on the beach.
Just fighting to see life is frightening. We're seeking enlightenment, but the lightning never strikes twice in the same place. Despite it, we writing, write down our wrongs and try to right them. Rising, see the horizon, get blinded. The sunlight, the something like life coming to rise. It's life like they say that you live and then you die. But what's before that? What's after it? If I could find the answers, then maybe I could just capture it. Trying to find the pastures of happiness, I ain't having this. There's gotta be more to the book in which my chapter is. Will my music live on when my chapter ends? Stacking ends to the moment that I crash the pens. Would it be light at the end of the tunnel? I just try to manifest the life that I wanted.
Still don't know what I'm searching for, but with all that's out there, I know there's something more, yeah. Still don't know what kind of peace I found, but I'm a single la-di-da till I'm in the ground. Oh,
you can rely on me like the family dog. I stick around like the peas in the pod. Guess that sedative got me on the repetitive. I've had time to reminisce, so like better live. Don't need no sign that the future's bright. Cause I'm alive where it started at mellow jams. Good people in the lava lamp. Rather that than knowing to the bank, man. It's got me thinking that life makes you rich, but money makes you a poor man. This ain't war, man. Just look at the score, man. With my last 20 thunderstorms forecast for here, but the sky is clear, man. And that's heavy. And the tide's pulling me, the system's killing me. My freedom's calling me, but we're too blind to see. Believe me, relieve me. I take time to take my mind off things. Easy, because my dreams are free for me. I take it easily and easily takes me. I take it easily and easily takes me.
Because I'm alone from the highs of my peaks. I keep searching for the peace that I see. Catch your eyes by the mountain, set by the sea. Together by the fire, sitting on the beach.
You're on Beach FM 106.3, and that's a No Problem Labos and Ladi Da. And now we're going to go check out some weather.
Beach FM weather, where today's weather is weather to have Fisherman's Table daily deals today or tomorrow. Fisherman's Table Pai Kakariki, tasty meals, fresh salad bar. Open 7 days on State Highway 1.
All right. They say it's going to get cloudy and it's going to rain a bit tonight. I can't see that as yet, but it does look like a little bit of rain out here at Lindale at the moment. But temperature-wise, it's still warm. It hasn't dropped down really at all. It's still between 17 and 18 degrees from the Kapiti Coast through to the Manawatu. Dropped down to 14 degrees in Wellington City. Overnight, it's not going to get much colder than that. It's dropping down to 13 degrees in Kapiti, Manawatu and the Horowhenua, and 12 degrees in Wellington City. Tomorrow, Labor Day, the 28th of October, for our entire region, early rain clearing and becoming mainly fine with high cloud and nor'westerly winds. Temperature-wise, very similar to today, 17 in Kapiti and the Horowhenua, 18 in the Manawatu and 16 in Wellington City. All right, looking over at the tides, it is high tide at 3 past 10 this evening, which means the low tide will be at 4:15 in the morning. Sun will set at 6 minutes to 8.
Beach FM traffic proudly brought to you by the world-class Southwood Car Museum. Relax amongst motoring history with 500-plus rare and exotic vehicles and other exhibits right alongside the coffee shop. Call them 04297 1221 or visit online.
Right, the roads are actually all good. Only heavy part is through Otaki. Before, there's actually not much of a hold-up, but it's going rather slow just looking at the webcam there going through the actual township. Other than that, we're all good. So, but tomorrow I think it will be chaos on the roads heading back to Wellington, so I'll try to avoid that. On the trains, there isn't any. There's only buses, and it's such a fun time if you've taken the buses into Wellington. You get to see a lot of different places, but that's what it is. I suppose they do have to have time to do maintenance on the tracks, and that's what they do. But our mates over at the airport at Air Chatham have things under control, and everything is running to schedule. It's actually probably quicker to fly to Auckland than it would be to take the bus into Wellington, to tell the truth, but there you go. That is life. Right, we're going to get back in and we're going to be chatting to our two guests, Cerid and Theo. They don't know which one's going to talk. They're pointing at each other now. The panic's on because here at Beach they have to share a mic, so they get nice and up and close and personal. on there. You don't rap by any chance, Theo? I've been trying to get someone to do a rap for me.
No, I don't rap, no. I did once upon a time, but I think we'll just leave that one in the past year.
Yeah, leave that to Will, eh? We have to get him back for a rap and Christian beatbox.
Is that Will I Am or whatever from them? No. All right, so, hey, the date is looming pretty quickly. What I'll probably do talk about is, are you doing the cheese live on the day? Or which day?
Yeah. So weather dependent, but I'm hoping to get out there every day of the Arts Trail on both weekends and the mornings out there painting that cheese, yeah.
Is it your first cheese?
It's definitely my first cheese, yeah, so it's very exciting.
Yeah. Well, it is pretty iconic. The pressure on you must be a bit.
Because it is iconic, hey. Yeah, I mean, it's kind of silly, but it's also iconic at the same time.
When I was doing my Saturday sports show, I'd get guests coming up here to interview, and I'll be trying to tell them where they are. Where's that? And especially the younger ones, because the older ones always knew Lindale, but the younger ones never did. And I'm like, the place where the cheese is. And they're like, oh, I know where that is.
Everyone remembers the cheese, especially my generation sort of growing up, sort of climbing all over it and all that sort of stuff when you're up here at Lindale.
You could do that. You could just do kids climbing all over the...
Maybe.
Maybe. We'll see. He thought that was a dumb idea. Like, look at his face. He just said, yeah, whatever, I'll just tolerate him. But that's good.
I'm open to ideas.
I'm not a sensitive guy, so it's all good. And my mummy told me that no idea is a dumb idea. She might have been just appeasing me as a young fella, but that's the way it does. So, Cerid, you got a lot to do between now and next Saturday?
Oh, no, of course not. It's a walk of cake. A walk of cake.
There you go. Sure. I try not to walk on my cake before I eat it, but hey, each to their own. I don't judge.
It's tenderizing, you know. There are a few bits and pieces left to do for sure, but I have full faith. I mean, there's just been so much to do consistently. Mm-hmm. I've barely had more than like 4 days off, I think, in my last like 35 days. There's a little bit left to do, but I have full faith that everything's going to come together and be fantastic. Hanging all the work of all the guild artists this Wednesday night, we'll be doing that, and that's really exciting. I'm really looking forward to seeing all the work go up on those walls that I've worked so hard with an amazing team of people to get up there. So,
is there like a pre-Arts Trail like inspection where you come along with a few drinks and stuff and have a look at it?
We haven't organised anything like that at this point.
I was just trying to get free drinks. I was just thinking that'd be quite good.
Hey, well, Brendon, I'm up here nearly every day. Pop on over to the barn, see if we're around. There's usually a beer in my car. We can probably sort you out.
Sounds good to me. All right, now we're going to pick it up. We've picked another song. What's your next song there, Kieran?
Sunday afternoon. What else could it be but lazy Sunday afternoon?
And you say that so well, love.
Oh, we got no time to worry, mate.
No time to worry. All good.
The Beach FM Sunday Afternoon Show with Paraparamu Taxis, your friendly team at your service 24/7. Just call 296-1111.
Wouldn't it be nice to get on with me neighbours? But they make it very clear they've got no room for raiders.
We're on Beach FM 106.3, and that's the Small Faces and Lazy Sunday Afternoon. And we're going to go to a small break, and then we'll be back talking to Cerid and Theo.
I miss my prepaid. You complete me with extra data.
Just shut up. You had me at hello. Can I get a top up?
Love prepaid that loves you back with Spark. Stack up more and more data every month we're together. Ignite our prepaid relationship today at spark.co.nz/prepaid. Eligible pack required. Data stack T's and C's apply.
Visit the 17th annual News Talk ZB Paraparaumu Rotary Art Show at Southwood Car Museum over Labour Weekend. Your $5 door sale ticket guarantees multiple entry over the long weekend between 10 and 4. School-aged children are free. Come simply to see and enjoy or buy from a large range of diverse paintings from talented artists. The art show supports local arts and the Kapiti Performing Arts Centre. Guest artists this year are Holly Chapman, Caroline Beaufort and Sam Lurie.
Right, you're on Beach FM, and we're back with Cerid and Theo, and we're talking all about art and the Lindale Arts Guild and the Art Trail. There is so much art on the Kapiti Coast, isn't there?
Oh, just so a bit.
Yeah, there is. And there has been talk over the years of renaming, like they're always talking about different things to promote the Kapiti Coast, and I don't think they've come up with quite the right term to promote us as artists yet.
Oh, I think Kapiti was called Creative Coast for a while. Yeah. There was even an online directory that was set up that was Creative Coast.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, it is, there's one, a Nature Coast, Creative Coast.
Yeah.
It has been thrown around there before. I mean, like I said before, we've got so many artists here. So.
Crazy Coast would be good.
Crazy Coast, yeah. I'm going with that. I like that, the Crazy Coast. The Crazy Coasters. So, I think we could go with that. On there, but the Arts Trail obviously tries to pull all this in together and display some of our top artists out here, or different artists as well.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Arts Trail's been running for a long time. I went to Arts Trail probably first when I was about 14, 15, so more than 15 years ago now. And it's developed and changed so much over that time span. It used to be very much walking into artist studios and you'd sit down and have a cup of tea and flick through sketch pads and things like that. Whereas now I think it's got so big. I mean, like I say, there's more than 100 different artists. We've got 20 odd here, and that's just one hub. So I mean, there's a lot out there. There's a lot to show and share. But I mean, I think it now being over two weekends, it would be really exciting to have a little bit more than just two weekends of Arts Trail. And what could we do in that week between? There's so much more than just artists in Kapiti. We've got really creative musicians. We've got creative writers. I mean, if you can think of a creative field, I could guarantee you we've got some real talent here in Kapiti. It'd be nice to see some more of that happen, I reckon.
It would. Sounds like a plan.
Agreed.
Now, agreed.
Live mural work, maybe?
Yeah. Now, actually, on that note, you were talking about sketch pads and stuff like that. Do you, like for the cheese, for example, do you sketch something out, or you just look at it and you get inspired and start?
Yeah, like that second one, mainly. I don't do a lot of sketching these days. It's more sort of sketching in my brain a bit. I just kind of stare at it for ages, and that's my sketch.
If people come up and you're just standing there, you're about to start, but you're just waiting.
Yeah, just working it out in my mind.
You could probably go watch a whole lot of old Walt Disney movies with Mickey Mouse and stuff, get inspired for cheese.
Yeah, well, hey, that's not a bad idea, actually. Yeah. I like that one.
Is that better than my last one?
It's definitely better than the last one.
Excellent, thank you. I'm getting better here. See, there's
the creative talent's rubbing off.
This is how we do it. We get ideas flowing and good things happen.
My favourite character was Goofy. I thought he was pretty cool, but that's where it goes. Yeah, so we're definitely looking forward to seeing it. And we're going to film that while you're doing it? Is there going to be a bit of filming?
I believe the team up here at Umbrella Multimedia have just been amazing at offering their skills to help out. So I'm not employed by anyone up here. These guys, Umbrella Multimedia, is sort of how I've ended up here.
Does that mean they just get you to go do a whole lot of work without paying you? Is that the deal?
It's a labour of passion, and I think this idea is so much bigger than any individual.
Yeah.
And it's about pulling all these different creatives together from different fields. So, I mean, having an amazing studio film and media experts who are just absolutely fantastic. They're so much fun to work with. They've done this film, but the advert that we did before was really great.
Yeah.
The biddies, absolutely. Yeah. I actually did the set design for that, which was fantastic. But they are going to be doing some live filming on the day. I think we're going to do two things. One is they'll have a few Facebook live stream stuff happening, as well as Clement, the cameraman, and we'll get out there and have a
French wine.
Oh yes, very French, very French. It's very funny when he drinks a few wines, he becomes very, very French.
I've had a few wines with Clement. He's a very good man.
He sure is, yep. So he'll be filming some of Theo's work. He's pretty keen to get involved into that, I believe.
Yeah. Oh, very cool, because I love those artist ones when they do the speed, like they take it over time and then they speed it up, so you see the whole, like in 1 minute you see the whole artwork.
Yeah, a couple of time-lapse.
Yeah, time-lapse sort of stuff onto there.
Yeah, it's amazing, seeing the process of it all come together.
They could set up one of those hunting cameras that are just they're activated by the...
by movement.
By movement, yeah, right. They could set that up there, that'd be quite cool. Hey, it sounds good, and it sounds like it is going to be a pretty cool weekend on there at all. But we're going to go, and we're going to play one last track from you, Theo, and then we'll come back, and you can say your thank yous and your goodbyes and all that sort of stuff. So we'll see you later, and we can go from there. So what's your next track there, mate?
Awesome. Yeah, here's another song I've been jamming a little bit lately. It's called Medicine by Rising Appalachia, I think I say that correctly.
Well, hey, you probably did better than I would, so we'll go with that.
All right,
here we go.
Beach FM, locals talking to locals. brainwashing is violence, and so is your silence when it's rooted in compliance. To stand firm in loving defiance, make art your alliance, give voice to the fire. Move people to the beat of the wind, gather yourself and begin to dance the song until it ends. We are winners, champions of the light, forming in numbers and might. Keep the truth close in sight. Medicine woman, medicine man, walk in with grace. I know your face and I trust your hand. Medicine woman, medicine man, walk in with grace. I know your face and I trust your hand. Find your teachers in the voice of the forests. Unplug, you can't ignore this wisdom of the voiceless. Remedies are bountiful and surround us from the garden to the farthest. Pray you're made of stardust. Find your healing in the music that calls you, the voice that enthralls you. What do you belong to? Eyes up, there's the setting of the sun. Give thanks to each and everyone. The lesson is the medicine woman, medicine man. With grace, I know your face and I trust your hands. Medicine woman, medicine man, walk in with grace, I know your face and I trust your hands.
Start the disbelieving, cause the garden holds the shards, the medicine is in the seeds. When we hold tight to our right to protect, and we know our might is tenfold in connection. Our elders hold them bright lights, we protect them. The medicine is evident, the wolf, the hawk, the bear clan. We hold tight to our right to protect, and we know our might is tenfold in connection. Our elders hold them bright lights, we protect them. The medicine is evidence, the wolf, the hawk, the medicine woman, medicine man. Walk in with grace, I know your face and I trust your hands. Medicine woman, medicine man. Walk in with grace, I know your face and I trust your hands.
Right, you're on Beach FM, and that's Medicine by the Rising Appalachia. Oh, we think I got that right, but that was Theo's choice. We're going to go play an ad, and then we'll be back for Cerid and Theo to say their thank yous and one last song from them.
Is your four-legged friend looking like something the cat dragged in? Getting your best friend groomed can be stressful for you and the dog, but not always. At the Pet Shop in the Wereroa Village, Oxford Street within, they have Anna and Holly. They're the calmest, smoothest operators you and your dog will be lucky enough to know. Experienced groomers and able to work with any and all breeds of dogs, from the hairiest to the smelliest. Turn Harry McCleary or Cousin It into the most sleek and cuddly version of your dog. Make an appointment now. The Pet Shop, 06367-993.
Spring into your local Paper Plus Levin for exciting new books, both fiction and non-fiction, leading into Christmas. Calendars and Christmas cards are now out as well, so if you need to post overseas, we are your one-stop shop. 2020 diaries are also now available. Your locally owned Paper Plus has it all from post to pages.
Paper Plus, 201 Oxford Street, Levin.
Right, you're on Beach FM with Brendon, Cerid, and Theo. And just a little bit more time for a wind-up. Theo, you're up.
Cheers, thank you. I just want to say thank you for having me here, Beach
FM. You're welcome. Yeah. Hey, if you need more ideas for your artwork, I'll give you my number. Just keep in touch.
Cool, man. That sounds good. Yeah. And catch me up at the Lindale Hub for Arts Trail this weekend. Yeah.
Cool, sounds good. All right.
And hi, Mum.
Oh, hi. Yeah. Hi, Theo's mum. Thanks for listening. Yeah.
I've got a little bit of a list here. A few people I really need to thank. One is DJ at PV Electricals for help with the electricals at the barn. Yvette and the team at Anzal have kept me going with coffee every day. It's been amazing. A special thanks to Andor for all the extra help he's given around the place. James Davenport for his tree cutting in order to make the area for the cheese ready for Theo to make his magic on. Kanglenny Binding for all the help with the building. Mike at Acacia Books up here for helping organise the residents and cleaning up after the mess that I make every time I'm up here. Ross at Audio Works for helping out getting all the pallets, as well as offering us some equipment for the live music that we'll have going. So a thanks to all my Muso friends who are coming to help out. Obviously the Umbrella Multimedia team. A big shout out to Rosie at the Arts Council for all her support and encouragement. A massive thanks to all the artist guilds and the studio artists opening and coming with us here for the hub, and all my mates for the encouragement consistently. Thank you so much, and cheers Brendon for having us. It's been awesome, mate.
You're welcome. You've been fun having in here. I'm glad you moved on to the mic, but because before the early hours, she was in the back controlling matters from the back, like the master of ceremonies with her large whip and things to keep them in line.
It's tugging on the strings here and there, you know, it's necessary.
And it is brilliant because none of the artists have dropped the F-bomb, which is brilliant.
And I didn't either. Yeah. I'm actually quite happy with myself for that. I really thought if anyone was going to slip up, it was going to be me. So there you go.
Sounds good. What was that? Liar. That's right. Hey, we can chat for another couple of minutes, actually, because we'll play your last song. You can tell us about it. We'll play it after the news at 5, because I knew you weren't going to get yours done in 40 seconds. thank
you. But Brendon knows me.
Yeah, I can tell your listeners what you can tell the listeners about the song you did, your last song.
Oh, this is Gorgo Bordello, I believe is how you say it. It's a lovely mouthful, and the song is Start Wearing Purple, and it's a Romanian gypsy. It's my feel-good song, so it's what I jam every time I'm having a bad day. So start wearing purple for me now.
It's a lovely mouthful.
It is. And listeners, you missed the facial expressions that Cerid was doing at the same time. I think it was very important for how she pronounced the words to have those facial expressions. But I'm going to look forward to hearing that, and I reckon I'm going to make that part of my playlist because it sounds like...
Purple socks. My father always wears purple socks he needs them.
Well, you know that purple is the colour of emperors.
And
we actually lost your life if you wore purple in ancient Rome, because only the emperor could wear purple. So
emperor's new clothes, eh?
Yeah. You could see these ones though, but hey, it was National Nude Gardening Day yesterday, so you.
No one told me.
Oh, it was advertised around, but yeah, I know, it was a shame.
Did you say nude gardening?
Yeah, nude gardening. It's national.
I thought that was every day.
Yeah, I thought so too until my neighbours rang the police and started complaining. But
no sense of humour, clearly.
No, exactly. But that is the way it goes. Right, guys, it's been a pleasure having you in here, and I'm sure it will be a huge success next weekend. Absolutely. And billions of people will turn up.
Oh, yes, we look forward to seeing everyone, and they're all hordes of creative spirits. Yeah. Like the wonderment, remember?
It's the wonderment, and bring... No, yeah, go there.
I was just going to say wonderment.
Wonderment, yes. And listeners, bring your wallets, because that always makes it a better day for the artists if you buy some stuff. I'm sure you can give donations to Theo as well while he's doing the cheese.
Oh, yeah, that'd be great. And I also like an almond flat white as well.
Okay, you got that, almond flat white. Ansel Cafe does almond flat whites.
They do, that's what I drink too, and they're the best, hands down. So there you go.
So we'll just start running a little thing down there. Just walk in and say, I want a Theo. you might ID by the end of the day on coffee, mate.
I have a pretty bad habit.
Well, they are licensed, so maybe a bit later on in the afternoon they can bring you something cool to cool you down.
That sounds good too. I take those donations as well.
Now, would you also, do you like people coming along who could sort of point out and give you suggestions while you're doing your artwork?
No.
All right, guys, I've got to go to the news, but it was a pleasure having you here.
Thank you, Brendon.
Thanks, guys.
Cheers.